It's you. Come on in. Come check out the playground. Office that I started renting after the Reverie Writers Room closed, and I had over the years amassed a few toys and artwork and things like that, and there weren't really places to really put them in the apartment to set it all up. And so I started renting a small office here in Glendale, and it really became kind of just a place for me to come and submerge myself in the things that I love. I remember here in Guillermo del Toro, like, I think he basically bought a house and filled it with all of his life-size statues of Frankenstein and Lovecraft, and it was just really the place to go and connect with the things that he was inspired by. So that's a lot of what I have here. This is kind of like the little seating area conversation space. This is some artwork that I bought an artist that I saw in Orange County. Right when I sold Extant, I went to this gallery showing, and these pieces really spoke kind of to the themes of the show. There's find me, help me, protect me, save me, and they actually kind of relate to Reverie too. So that's one of the centerpieces. You'll see I have a little bar cart here. There's a little Yoda cookie jar, a little TARDIS cookie jar, some bourbon, some alcohol, which we can break into here in a little bit. And then I have a little shelf here, some Yoda, who's one of my favorite characters of all time. That's a Force Trainer Yoda. There's a little kind of ray gun sculpture that my season one Extant showrunner Greg Walker got for me. And then this is a piece of artwork from CBS. They gave me this after Extant was canceled. This was a consolation prize, which was a piece of artwork that was hanging up in Television City, I think. So it's like one of the biggest pieces of artwork I have for one of the shows. I don't have one for Reverie yet, but maybe soon. Let me show over here. It's a little toy. Toys and books and things. I have a lot of these, you know, pop figures for different things. But then this is the Twilight Zone shelf. So these are actually from a guy named Chris Ender at CBS, one of the publicists there. Saw me taking a picture of him. I was laying, you know, on the ground taking a selfie of myself with the Twilight Zone brick. And I told him I was a big fan of it, and then he sent me all this stuff. So I have a ton of cool little figurines, collectibles from the Twilight Zone, which is one of my all-time favorite shows, one of my heroes. This is a little globe that my mom got me. It's a little, well, she got me this for my office for Extant. And it's the Earth inside a little thing. There's a little, kind of like the overview effect that astronauts talk about. You get to hold it in and look at it. This is my picture. This was a closing gift from Hallie. That together we realized a dream. Oh, this, I gotta show you this. So my friend Jason Jenkins, Jinx, made me this, I think for Christmas. And this is a Molly Woods action figure that he had custom made, and she's got her own packaging, she's got her own description on the back, and this is the Hybrid Eyes variant, which I thought was very cool, using this artwork that had been designed for us by a guy named Oliver Barrett, who did a little kind of commemorative piece for me on season two, so it's kind of cool. I'll show you this. This is Wilson Auditorium. This is a brick that one of my classmates, now drama, head of the drama department at University of Cincinnati's College Conservatory of Music, sent to me. Wilson Auditorium was like the black box space, and it's where you had all your acting classes, and they tore it down, and he sent me a brick, and I keep that with me because it's kind of where I got started from a lot of this stuff. Come on, I'll show you over this. This is from WonderCon when we went to show Reverie. This is from New York Comic Con, South by Southwest, which we went to this year. In the classic Cribs parlance, I guess this is where the magic happens. Did you ever do a lot of my writing? It's a lot of writing facing this way, and then a lot of turning the chair this way and staring out the window for a while. So my laptop, which I do most of my writing on, and then the desktop with the monitor is really primarily to run the Oculus, which I bought last year because writing a show about virtual reality, I felt like I wanted to play with it. I hadn't really experienced it a lot. So up here I have the family pictures, me and Julie and our little dog Ellie, also known as Ellie Bear, also known as Bubby or Bubby Bear. She has a lot of nicknames. But Julie got these for me for my birthday last year. So I keep them close. Sometimes, and Ellie actually has her little spot over here. Sometimes I bring her, she's got a little mat and her games and her little her dish to keep her busy while she's here.
These are two pieces that were set deck from Exton. And I got a call from the season two showrunners, Liz and Craig, and they were rummaging around at CBS for something and called. They had found these, and so I spirited them away and put them on my wall. This is one of two things that were on the space agency in season one. This is a piece of artwork from Reverie from our assistant, Tasha Sabelli, the editing assistant. She did one of these for every episode. This is one for my episode 110 called Point of Origin. Standing desk, which I do not much writing on. I tend to do more reading, and if I'm watching an episode of something or cuts of stuff, I tend to do it standing up so that I can break up the day by not sitting the whole day. I don't use the treadmill as much as I used to, mostly because I'm walking my dog a couple times a day, so I don't really walk as much, but I do stand here a lot to have a view out the window so I can read. I can write here a little, but I tend mostly just to, like, this is where I go for entertainment. This is my Amblin shelf. This is all sort of like classic stuff from my childhood. Get Stripe, E.T. is a little spaceship, original board game, still in the packaging. I'm only gonna open, there's one special occasion I'm gonna willing to open it, but that's later. Got some stuff from Jurassic Park, have the DeLorean, Chunk, who was basically like, that's kind of who I was as a kid. This was made for me by one of the, Linda, one of the ladies, hair and makeup ladies from Extant. Oh, I have this, this is Abraham Satrakian from The Strain, which I got to write on The Strain for the final season, and he was one of my favorite characters to write for. There's some stuff here from a store called Goldbug in Pasadena, which is one of the coolest places I've ever been. Like this horseshoe crab, and like these lamps. They have a ton of stuff there that I would love to outfit this whole office with. Oh, there's I found this recently. I was in Houston. This Twilight Zone comic book. It was actually one of the comic books from the 60s that was actually written by Mr. Serling as well. So I picked up a couple of those. One for my friend Jason Jenkins, who I told you about earlier. And then this one is the one that I kept. So that is it. That is basically the whole tour. And I got some cards in the wall. I've been doing a little work today, which I should probably get back to. So you don't have to go home, but you can't stay here. So this way.